If you have a strong purpose in life, you don't have to be pushed. Your passion will drive you there. Good afternoon, everybody. I, Prithya Malhotra, take immense pleasure in breaking open this session for the audience with Mr. Neeraj Sharma, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer, Indian School Finance Company. Mr. Sharma completed his BCom and Chartered Accountancy from Delhi. Sir is an extraordinary professional posing as a commoner with a vast, expansive corporate journey spanning 28 years across 11 companies like ACC India, BIL, AIG Home Finance Limited, Fullerton India Credit Limited, and Media Video Limited. I thus take absolute honor to hand over the reins of this session to Mr. Sharma.
First of all, I'd like to extend my sincere thanks to the college for offering me to come and speak. I don't have any formal presentations per se, but what I thought is, let me just share my experience with you guys, that what works and what doesn't work. See, eventually all of us join corporate life to make money and grow in life. So I would like to share my experience that from senior officer to CEO, what it took me to reach this place. Right? I'm going to begin first with the background. I was not born in a rich family. My father was a banker. Transfers, regular transfers. I know that till 6th I was in private schools. After that, my father was posted at a place where the nearest government school was from 5-6 kilometers away. So, from that background, I would say in government schools I studied. I did my CA, ICWA all fresh out. Now, after that, then started the corporate journey. My ambitions, I always kept very high. I used to study in my 12th standard. There were some management books which I used to study, and I used to see myself that yes, I am an entrepreneur, and if this situation comes to me, how will I take that decision? And believe me, those thoughts, those dreams, they are helping me now, what I had done that time, and how to take the decisions. My first company was RR Finance. I am also going to share the decisions which I took in terms of my career, should I leave the company, should I not, and how it has worked. This company, in my 22 years career, is 13th company wherein I have joined. So in one of my interviews, in my third or fourth company, one of the managing directors of the company asked that you are changing too frequent. What is the guarantee that you will stay here? So I said, yes, there is a guarantee. If you give the guarantee that you will not sack me, I am here. So long you will take care of my aspiration, I am here. Otherwise, I will also quit. So I joined a company called ACC. Largest human manufacturing company of India through campus equipment way back in 1995. My job was to go in a lot of plants. I joined in management audit. So the job was to go in various plants and study what the management has decided, whether the policies are implemented properly or not. If I see, you know, recently in our company we hired people from institute, even institute. In today's generation, I would say that hard work somewhere is absent. This is what our perception is. I'm not telling about you guys, but this is the perception which in the industry we have, that what is happening to the new generation, that we are finding, They are not working that hard which we back then initially as we used to work. So my first suggestion to you all guys is that do not take shortcut. Management definitely keep keeps an eye on each and everybody, and the way we select our next people is that we give a lot of work to them, load them, and then we see how they reacted to the situation. So when we are hiring people, we are very much aware that you are just graduate, just fresher, as far as knowledge is concerned. You have bookish knowledge. What we look at from industry is the attitude in you guys. But is there attitude to learn? Is a person street smart and gets his work done? So these are some of the things which we look at. So in ACC, the first thing which I learned was, one of my boss was there, and whenever I used to go to him that okay, this plant has this problem, he always used to ask me, where is the solution? Right? Not only you have to give me problem, but give me solution also. And solution also should not be just for the sake of it. I had to go to him with some savings. That okay, if you implement this solution, the company will get this much savings. So from that company, from that boss, I learned that not only identify the problem, but find a solution, and find a solution which you can implement the results into some concrete savings in terms of time, money, or resource. I kind of visited entire India when I was 25 years away to this ACC. Traveling, again, I would say, you guys should be open to travel, and that broadens your outlook, and that will help you in your later years. Meeting people, how they are thinking, how they are reacting to situations, will make you intelligent. From ACC, I joined a company which was Bridgestone ACC Limited. Bridgestone back then was setting up plant in India to manufacture radial tires. I had a Japanese boss who was 65 years of age, black belt, and this guy was always on my nerve, where is my data? Now I gave you this work, and where is that, when you're not completed so far. So my standard advice is, sir, I'm doing slowly and slowly. So one day he got fed up with that slowly and slowly. He asked, come to my company. So I went, and then he said, next time I don't want to hear the slowly and slowly. He said, why you Indian cannot do 3-4 things simultaneously? Why you have to do just one thing one at a time? So then from that point of time, I am sure that I am doing multitasking. So with my experience, I'm sharing, I'm not just, I hope I'm not boring you, I'm just sharing that these things, how they will help you. What learnings I had, what my bosses need, what were their requirements, I'm just sharing with you, because when you'll be joining the corporate world, pretty much these were the, these would be the things which your superiors will be asking of you. So multitasking is one of the things that when people give you a job, just don't get fixated on one thing. Keep doing simultaneously many things. And that depends also on your job, what job you have. We used to work very hard. You know, I remember once I went to my home 3 days. I was sleeping in plant doing some work. That boss used to scold me a lot, and I would say, today what I am, from 80% credit I give to that fellow. The reason is the bad boss, bad boss is wrong, what I would say, boss is who pushes you hard. He is polishing you. He is making your edges move. So do not fear that boss, or do not fear that superiors. He is just helping you to get your edges move. From there, I joined a company, which was year later. I got married, and I was in Indore, in Bristol, India. Wife was from Delhi, wife said it's a jungle, so I got tried to leave the jungle. So I kind of went back to Delhi. There was a company called Purolator. Purolator, the way I used to describe, and At this time, I was heading accounts of Bridgestone India. My boss, when I resigned, the Japanese boss, he said, why are you going? Of course, wife, Bahana, I didn't want to wait. So I said that my father is alone and he wants to be back in Delhi. So of course, he used a word that, you know, for families, we are still like babies, right? But we know who you are. So same thing I would say to you guys also. Corporate, your superiors, they would understand you, they would recognize your potentials, and they will polish you. So their assessment of yourself versus your friend, family, relatives' assessment will be quite different. Curator, I got a boss, and there was a fellow. I was in treasury department. So this fellow was very hardworking. I used to leave around, say, 7 o'clock. I was in the Gama going back to Delhi. This guy used to be there with the company 8-9 every day. And I used to think, very hardworking guy, can I be like him? So once he was transferred to some other department, and I was given his job. And I found that what is there in this that he was trying to aim for money. Right? So that said, the point is, smart working is also very important. Most of the time, people do same thing, same way, years and years. We do not put our minds into why we are doing this, how can we reduce the timing. So some processes rejigs were done and, you know, the timing was better. You know. So learning from that organization was the smart working. The learning from the boss of that company was, he was very good in figures. He used to have the book and he used to have all the figures with him. So that was the learning, that you should be on top of your numbers, where the numbers are moving, how they are moving, what should be done to ensure that they are in the right fashion. From there, I joined a company called Tipcom. Tipcom was a joint venture between Indian Telecom Industries of government and Telex of USA. Again, there was a very tough boss. The boss was kind of terror in the company. And since I was in the finance department, so there was a lot of things which I had to do with. And this was the boss who asked me, that's why you are changing of so frequently. My seniors, immediate seniors, they used to send me to his cabin because they were fearing going inside. From there, I kind of learned that what exactly this person is looking, why he's angry. So I found that, you know, he's angry not with the junior team, but with the senior team, because the expectations what you have from your junior teams versus your senior teams, they are quite different. Again, going back to the point which I was saying, you know that you are pressured, you know that immediately you cannot do much of the thing. So same thing here also applies, and there one of my boss was very good on control numbers. If I used to take my numbers to him, he used to always find some mistake that this number is wrong. And I used to wonder why he's saying that this number is wrong. And when I used to go back, actually that number used to be wrong. From him I learned that how you should control your control numbers. Right? There are that, okay, you need to have some figures, etc. But there are some control numbers which, if they go here and there, you can find out that something has gone missed. So this control numbers should also be kept in mind, which is essentially MIS. It means you should have an eye to detail. Things should be seen in a broad and macro level. From that company, I joined a company called Balapur Industries. Balapur Industries is the largest paper manufacturing of India. I had a very tough boss again. The boss, I would say, is And I was in Treasury Department, so I was to borrow money from the markets. The company was not doing that well, even a small amount for us was a big amount. So we always about those. I was not happy with my boss. I once complained against him to his boss. The boss said, because of you, I'm going to fire this guy. And this was an issue on some holidays and all. So, and he told me this one thing, that family first, work later, because you can find another job, but you can't find another family. So this is one of my, motto, that few things I'll tell you about it, please, attacking. But yes, the learning from that organization was, and this is what he said to me, you need to learn how to manage your bosses. Well, I say manage means what expectation he has from you, how to make, because bosses normally, when they give you jobs, they have some pressures from somewhere else. When they tell you that, okay, I need this job done in so and so time period, it means he's also having some deadline from somewhere. And if you're not meeting those deadlines, definitely he's going to shout at you. It's not that I was not doing my job properly. My analysis about boss was that he was kind of getting into it. But having said that, then I decided to be, I said, no, I don't want to work for the company. And then I joined the company, which was Media Video, a small team can come in front of industry. That company relieved me of the fear of job. I used to get salary in 2 months. But from there, I found that, okay, even if I don't get the salary, even if I don't have the job, how to survive? The boss there was, of course, he was good at heart, but currently he was not that strong. He used to ask me certain things. Initially, my reactions used to be, is it possible? Can I do this? Can this happen? But when I used to go back and give it a try, it happened. I remember I was given a task to acquire 100 acres of land in Germany. But I said, where is the money? The money back then was 60 crore rupees we wanted to have. And we were having some 10-12 crore rupees of money. He said, don't worry, just give them the token and the rest we'll see before the balance and we'll do. And believe me, that money came also. I was really surprised that he could pull this through. Otherwise, we would have lost 10-12 crore rupees. From this fellow, one thing which I learned is how to stay afloat, how to ensure that the things which looks very difficult to you, how to make them happen. He had a son. I used to tell him that, okay, his company in the last few years, it's a Kamakura Satya Kavali. And after 2.5 years, his boss was very tough on me from Gulab Industries. He asked me back to join because my Excel skills were very good. I was doing a lot of modeling in the company. Again, there was a guy who used to manage cash flow of the company. Every day he used to manage how much money he got, how much he used to borrow. And he used to take some time holidays to manage his thing. So once he went on a holiday and the task was given to me, and I used to wonder how come he can make such a gross this thing that each Excel sheet cell is to say plus. To plan the cash flow using incorporate. Not only today you have to plan, you have to see beyond the bands, you have to see what is going to happen in 30 days, 60 days. I kind of made a model, an Excel sheet model only, and that Excel sheet model, not only Balapur is following, that model is being called Akulat in India and 2-3 other countries, and my son companies. That is still there. So he was impressed with my Excel sheet skills. And two, three softwares I made there, still are being done there. Now, I was called again because of these Excel sheet skills only. Now, had I burned the bridges, of course I said to him that okay, you know, I'm not happy at all. But to his credit, he said one thing, that he acknowledged that, yes, I was not mistaken, it was passing him. And then I did do for company, I restructured the company, you know, I was given a task to restructure the company. He had six plants, three plants in one company, three plants in another. He sold stake to GIC, Singapore, and all. So the learning, if I have to draw from the Gulf industry, one is never burn your business, even in ground or say hard circumstances. If you are doing good, your boss still is watching you, he is observing you, and at the right time, he would call him back. And in fact, this boss again that was going somewhere, and I got a call of his job change reference. I definitely talk good about this guy. Now, from this company, I joined AIG. AIG is the largest insurance company in the world. Now, still Balaji Industries, I was in the manufacturing sector from, say, year 1995 to 2006. My salary growth was in tiny. Every year, you know, if I could get 7-8%, so people used to say, excellent, you got this much. From AIG, started the journey with service sector and then to financial sector. I was head treasury of AIG Home Finance and AIG Consumer Finance in India. The learning which I had from AIG, you know, AIG, I joined in 2007 and 2008 has to happen worldwide. First, when they gave money to this AIG, they put a condition that all gold core activities were to be done. So, again, learning that do not depend too much on one particular thing. So, again, I called back and they said, okay, we have to close down in India because of this EJ mandate. I remember in September again, I called my boss in the street. So, this guy said one thing to me that even if I have to create a job for me here, don't worry, I'll create. You're not being crazy, but somewhere else. That gave me some assurance. Right? And 2008, I don't know how many of you know, was it's a doomsday theory, right? It's just that entire financial industry is collapsing. AIG is kind of, it was as big as the GDP of India. It was that big. The bankers, they stopped our funding lines. So it was that magnitude the problem we had in 2008. So with that assurance, I started looking out, I got a job in Fullerton, India. My treasury size in AIG was 350 crore rupees. When I got a job in Fullerton, India, and the reason why I got a job was specialization. I was specialist in treasury. So again, the point that whatever you do, and share with you in such a manner that you become specialist for that particular field. Because of that, I went to Fullerton India, the treasury that time was 2,000 crore rupees. Again, I thought, I was managing 300, but how can I manage this 2,000 crore rupees, would I be successful or not? But I kept my cool and things happened. You know, I analyzed this 2,000 crore rupees and managed. I was kind of there, one of the best performing person in the company. Then came this interesting part of my life also. In this present company we are working, I have been to all places of town, finance, management, etc. Now, this company was a team kind of critical, this company was a great team. One of my friends whom I worked with in one of the banks, I worked. So he referred me to this company. That's what he left. So initially the reaction was no, I don't want to come because it's a very small company, I don't want to join it. because I was managing close to 4,000 crores in this project. But this entrepreneur book, I used to say that in first standard, I used to see myself, dream myself as an entrepreneur. That got again written me, and I joined this company. Then came, so from employee, I kind of became employer. Now today I am, one of the shareholders of this company or something. Managing, you know, what happens is when you are in a good condition, over time my money was just a phone call away, but minimum to the 500 crores. This company, I kind of factored each and everything that during bad times, when you go back to your acquainted people, they always say, it's okay, you know, just this, no, I just did this. Oh, sorry, I have a call, calculator. So I discounted all those things that things are going to happen to me when I joined the trophy company. Exactly those things happened. My ticket size was 100. The first borrowing which I did was of 2 crore rupees, and I was really, really happy. Okay, yes, I just borrowed 2 crore rupees in the company. Then came the change problem. I joined this company, the existing people, they saw me as a threat, and they were not kind of giving that kind of support, I would say. To send message, sometimes you are just saying from management, in the management have been, so all those decisions which my bosses used to take and I used to criticize, now I used to think that what my boss said me or did that particular time, am I thinking that way? Is this right or wrong? So what I decided is, let me give an atmosphere in the company which is good for employees, where employees, and this is one of my things, whenever I write a mail to my employees, I say that most of your awakened state, you are in the company. If you are not making this company, or this workplace, as a good workplace, and your atmosphere is nothing but you guys. So if you are not making atmosphere healthy, you will end up having some disease or frustration, and you will not be happy in life. So with that, I kind of started going after people, whosoever was not going the line. I just sacked one person, not many, but that was just to send a message that, okay, we have to fall in line, otherwise there will be some consequences. From there, today I would say our company, you know, I'll tell you what our company is. So our company is the first in the world, not only in India, in the world, who fund education sectors only education sector. We fund schools, different colleges, so I keep meeting school owners, college owners and all. Today, the people from various countries, they come to our company to do studies. How we are doing this? Normally, lending to schools and colleges is considered as a negative sector, that you know, we cannot close our school. And definitely that is not our intent also, to close our school. But when we select in such a manner that you know, the money would come back. Our NPA, if I see, our NPA is less than 2%. The banks, their NPAs are 89%. So today we have 350 crore rupees in AUM. Our profitability this year was close to 5 crore rupees. I'm raising capital. Just to name a few, you know, Asian Development Bank, they are after us, that we need to put in our company. So the company, what it was, what it is going to be, by the next goal or target is 3,500 crores of AUM. Again, all these things do happen if you are a dreamer. I used to dream. Dreams can be foolish, dreams can be anything high or low. But it's important for you guys to dream. If you are not dreaming, if your targets are very low, There are challenges we light up at the low door. Keep your attitude. In my company only, there are some people, your attitude is bad. Right? Nobody has in good spirits at all. So your attitude is very important. Learning will come next, but attitude is something which you have to have from the day one. Because if that is not there, growth, believe me, will be very difficult for you. Hard work, again, is important. Management, as I said earlier, also management tests you guys. It will test you to see, can you take extra load? There are some people, when I take interview also, most of the time I say, are you the type to say, ye mera kaam nahi hai? Because if you are that type, you don't need those kind of people. So we need people, even if it's not your work, can you do that? If you can do that, then yes, you are one of the selected few who are being considered for the higher post. Of course, you won't be given the next day, but you will be groomed in such a fashion that, you know, it's like the survival of the fittest. So management, keep looking at those guys who are, you know, going to become the next torchbearers. So my suggestion to you guys is that there is no shortcut to success. Health is very important. Most of our guys nowadays, I don't think so, they are taking care of health. Pehla soup, nirogi khaya, dusra soup, paasta khaya, right? So that first soup you should have, all of you. Otherwise, the second soup may not come, the first is not there. I would say pretty much this. My experience has been really great. One thing, you know, all my you and I realized, why did I quit my job? The one thing which I found as a common was frustration. That if you're frustrated, and frustration can have many things because of which you are frustrated. If you're frustrated, you start finding negatives in any situation. So important is, do not let the switch be off. You have to ensure that switch is off every time. It's important to have communication with your superiors, to go and discuss what you are feeling, what you are not feeling. But do not let this frustration creep into you, otherwise, you know, negativity will come in life. Man in Black, first part, I don't know how many of you have seen. The last part of Man in Black, the camera is panning out, right, from a town to a state to country, village, etc. So I stop myself at home, right, and I see that, okay, what Neeraj is doing on planet Earth. So if it's just office, home, something, he's wasting his time. So I would say, be creative also in your life. It's not only, you're not on planet Earth just to make money and think of that kind of thing. Live your life also, right? So, this is my some of my experience. I'll be happy to answer if you have any questions.
Hello, sir. This is Risha from Behind the Charity. My question is everybody is talking about cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin nowadays. So, how it will be used in the businesses and to what extent? Because on one end they are saying it's not that safe, and also it will come to an end when it reaches to the value of 21 million.
See, in business, anyhow, when we are getting funds from anybody, everything is in the bank account. Now, Bitcoin is what is nothing but a currency. I would say, to some extent, this currency is being used for maybe hawala or maybe say individual transaction. And to some extent, I would say, not to some extent, large extent, yes, for correction things and all. But I would say in India, already we are doing things from, so I don't think the Bitcoin currency in India would have any relevance whatsoever. In my personal opinion, I'm in it.